why is for.
He talks about himself.
But I can't talk about emails.
I was a little late.
I can't send out emails to Rollins for some reason. That's why you haven't had an email yet.
Let me go prepare and stay.
You could pass the word, 1:30 to 4.
30 minutes.
CTC in the medical assistant.
Make sure your statement is double spaced.
Thanks.
At least 3 pages. Times you really.
Times 12, fine, you know how.
All right, it looks like it is 6:30. It's possible we will have another student rep show up. Somewhat expecting another one to show up, but if not, we at least have one to carry on with, which is great. Call to order, please, the roll call.
Judy Nelson.
Here.
Tom Coons.
Here.
Emily Leach.
Here.
Andrea Anderson.
Here.
Erin Koff Kavanaugh.
Here.
All right, let us stand for the flag. The flag is on the stage. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, we will start with comments by visitors. Things that are on this agenda. Any comments from visitors? Visitors are all very carefully reading their material. All right, we will move on to the consent calendar. The consent calendar consists of minutes from our last meeting on August 9th and the enrollment update of August 28th. What is the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion to accept.
Can I?
Yeah, come right.
Minutes, please. Can I remove the minutes, please?
Yeah, so the minutes will be moved for, is that for making?
Correct. I have a couple of questions.
A couple of questions.
A question and a correction.
All right, so we'll move that down to discussion. Minutes have been removed. Do that first, actually, down in the discussion. And then the other is the, I can do it.
Enrollment?
The enrollment. The enrollment. And our enrollment is growing. Our kindergarten, the first grade, first, second, third, you can see where we're getting more folks coming in. And actually, and now that we're fully at Marshwood, the enrollment is up. But, so, in pleasure in accepting accepting the enrollment update.
Motion to accept the enrollment.
Our motion to.
I have a question about that, too. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. Let's just, we will leave those, we will leave minutes, I'm going to say minutes and enrollment.
They're really fast.
And we'll take it from there. So we're moving on. Those have been moved down to discussion items. Announcements. Any announcements from superintendents?
Just a couple of brief ones. Just a praise to all of the staff and students and the community members, because it was a great start to the school year in spite of all of the heat. We went through one heat wave, made it all the way through, and then had another one. So this building is not the easiest building to cool, and the staff and students just did a fantastic job. So I appreciate their efforts.
Yeah, here you go.
The infrastructure money that was applied for, we have tentatively been approved for the $63,492. 80% of that is $50,794. It still needs to go in front of governor and council, and I'm told that that's going to happen next week. I'm also told that that was the only project that was approved at the last meeting, so I think it stands a pretty good chance next week in front of governor and council. So we'll keep our fingers crossed that that's successful next week. And there were questions on the costs for the secure entry project in the back. said that in your October meeting, he should have firmer, or firm prices on that for your consideration. So I'll bring forward that in October.
All right, thank you. Well, we're on announcements. I wanted to clarify something that came up last, at our last meeting, and it was a question from a community member, Sharon, about something that appeared in the Salmon Falls Quarterly. And it was my mistake. I wrote that blurb for the Salmon Falls Quarterly, and the question was whether or not second graders, I think it's second grade, I have to look back now at some of the stuff that I took it from, whether or not second graders could actually be outside the annex, and they can. My source material, I mistyped. I mistyped it. It's K through 1 that needs to stay at the annex at ground level, and second graders are indeed okay to be other part of the building. That was my mistake, and I apologize for it. I need an editor, obviously. I need to send these things out. So I apologize for all that misunderstanding for that. Any other announcements? All right, and any communications announcements or separate communications that you want to discussion items. Let's start with the minutes.
Yeah, I just had one clarification at 7.1. It says that it's going to be the same cost per gallon, and I just want to clarify. I think that's actually the same rate per gallon, which is 18 cents over rack, which could be a different cost. And I just want to make sure when I speak with the budget committee that I have that accurately.
I understand what you're saying, that it's not going to be the same cost, it's going to be the same rate.
Right.
So we have to make sure that that's clear. And I think I pulled that out of my hand. I pulled out a bunch of stuff from that.
Contracts at 18 cents over our cost on the day of delivery.
Right, so the rate is remaining the same.
Right.
The cost is going to be whatever the cost is.
Yes.
So that's, I think it's saying that the town is getting the same cost per gallon that the school is getting.
It's, The price would be the same as last year, was my question.
Rate.
But the rate is what would be the same as last year.
Oh, I see.
So the price, it should say rate
instead of price.
Yep. Good catch. I will now have Emily read all of the things I wrote.
Also, just one mistake that I wanted to point out is that our town clerk's last name is Nesman. It's N-E-S-M-A-N, not Nesbitt, just so we have her in there correctly. That's all I have.
M-A-N?
N-E-S-M-A-N.
Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you. And we'll handle these two together. So enrollment?
We still have one student in the Summersworth District. Is that an accurate statement?
Yes, we do.
That was true.
Is that your question?
Yep.
All right. Then to the board, we will approve the minutes and the enrollment update. If you're willing to make a motion to do so.
I make a motion to approve the minutes and the enrollment.
Second. Second. Andrea, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We have and now we have the principal's report. I hope everyone had a chance to read it.
Mm-hmm.
Rich, are there things that you would like to
Yep, just a couple of things to sort of add but point out also. And I'll echo Dr. Kadomski's. We had a great start. We had a fantastic open house Tuesday evening. A lot of smiles, a lot of happy parents, a lot of happy kids, despite the heat. I think the highlight of the first day was popsicles that we had left over from field day. I heard that over and over again Tuesday night. So it's the little things sometimes that keep people happy. One of my sections was regarding Marshwood transition, so I gave you a little update on what I've done so far, but we've gone a little bit further. I did meet with our fifth and sixth grade teachers to fill them in about my tour and discussion with Principal Bourbon. And what we've proposed to them is to have us start by doing a half-day visitation at Marshwood Middle School, myself and the two teachers just visit the classrooms, more so to bring back information to our kids than necessarily change anything on our end. I'm the type of person, philosophy-wise, where I'm not going to come in the second week of school and say, well, we need to change all this because it's not working. I don't know if it's not working. So I think for them, they feel comfortable going. They've done some of this when we first made the transition to Marshwood 4 years ago. I believe they went over and did some visitations. They've got a connection over there with a couple of teachers that they talk to a couple times a year. So they knew that this was, you know, something that we need to continue to look at and build relationships with them. I also reached out to Principal Bourbon about having our sixth graders possibly attend some extracurricular activities during the year as guests. I was thinking maybe if they did a drama production during the school day or an extracurricular activity, an assembly for the whole school. He was very supportive of that and invited us to their talent show in February that they put on during the school day for kids. So that opportunity is available for our kids, and I'm going to actively seek any time that we can get them over there ahead of Step Up Day, just to get them used to being in the building and seeing kids that they used to go to school with here, and knowing that, you know, it's going to be a safe place for them to go to. And the last thing that he was thrilled with was I invited him to bring some wrongs for kids from the middle school back here. Talk to our sixth graders about their transition and the highlights that, you know, they enjoy about the school, and look fors, you know, the warnings that kids like to give kids coming up. And Principal Bourbon said that he would be willing to come with them to answer any questions our kids had. So we're going to set that up for about the middle of the school year.
That sounds great, and certainly the type of thing, just so that everyone knows, it isn't that things aren't going well with our going to Marshwood, it's just that there's always room for improvement, and it sounds like you've made some very good first steps, very, very good.
Yeah. And I know the assistant principal, you know, we worked in a similar area in northern New Hampshire, so when I went, we met and, you know, rehashed some old times as former athletic director, so I feel like we're going to have a pretty good connection and an open dialogue about, you know, needs on our part and needs on their part. So I look forward to that relationship.
That's great. Yeah. Any questions on the board for Rich on that?
No, it's wonderful.
So one other thing, Dr. Godomsky gave you a copy of our calendar, and a couple of staff members pointed out to me this week that in November we have, our students have a four-day weekend around Veterans Day. And on the calendar, it signifies that Veterans Day observed by the district is on the Friday, and the teachers have a workshop on the Monday, which is actually the observed Veterans Day holiday. So I guess the request being made is that could we switch it so that we're on the same schedule as everybody else?
You mean that everyone celebrates Veterans Day on the same day, and that Rollinsburg doesn't do it on the 9th, and everyone else does it on the 12th?
That
makes sense to me.
Yeah.
Same request.
Yeah. Seems like a very sane request. Plus, I mean, our school board meeting is on the 8th, so we expect, I think most of us expected there to be, I think it is the 8th, right?
Yeah.
So we usually don't have a school board meeting if there's a holiday fall. Try not to have an evening meeting or something. So I think this was just an oversight.
Yeah.
It won't affect students in our district at all because they have both days off.
Right.
It's just the staff members that it will affect.
Do we need a motion to change that?
I think we can do it by consent, or we better now a motion.
I think you can do it by consent. That's fine.
So I think so. No dissenting.
Be okay with that?
All right, so by consent will be...
Consider it done.
Changing those around, so thank you. I did want to note, well, we'll come back to this, stick around, we'll be talking, I noticed that part of your update was talking about the cupola, we'll be talking about that a little bit later as we get there. But, well, anyway, we'll talk about it when we get to that point. So, it's good, we've covered a lot of ground in the 2 weeks there. And now, drum roll please. Oh, all right, never mind the drum roll. We have a Marshwood student rep, Nicholas Garapi has stepped up, Garapi, right? Is that the right way to pronounce it? Because I hear many pronunciations around town, as you probably know. So, I'd like to introduce to everyone out there, Nick Garapi. And Nick, why don't you just take this opportunity to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, so I am a junior this year at Marshwood High School. I was in the school, Rollinsford Grade School, for all 7 years, from kindergarten all the way up to sixth grade. And I was a part of the class that was supposed to go to Summersworth for seventh grade, but instead I went straight up to Marshwood. So I spent my seventh grade year in Marshwood, and then all the way up until now, which is junior year. So I guess I have a little bit more experience than my peers in the Marshwood environment. Overall, it's been like a really nice experience. I really like the Marshwood School District, and it's been really nice. I hope that being on this board, I'll be able to kind of express how the students are feeling at Marshwood and how kind of things are going on the students' perspective. Yes, and I hope, I'm really interested in law and kind of going into a law profession when I graduate from high school and then hopefully go to college. And so I hope this opportunity will really help me kind of grow in that category.
That's wonderful. Well, welcome. We look forward to having you each week.
Each month.
You don't have to come. It's face just going to disappear. The report about what's going on in the school that maybe we'd all like to hear about, but also your perspective on how things are going. So that's really good. Do you want to share a little bit about what you're studying this year, what extracurricular activities you might be in this year with us?
Okay, so this year I'm really kind of focusing on my history classes because that's really what I want to go in, like I said. So I'm taking AP US History. And this semester I'm taking crime and justice to kind of, even though I'm not really interested in that category of law, just to kind of get that under my belt a little bit. And then next semester I'm taking world religions, just although that also isn't like what I want to really go in, it's just kind of nice to have more history classes under my belt. I'm also taking honors pre-calculus, which is considered the hardest class in the high school, and it is honors English 3, just kind of the basics, honors biology. So I'm happy I'm in all honors classes, but that AP US History really is trying to improve my history skills. And then next year I'm planning on taking AP Government, which will really get more into that kind of stuff I'm more interested in. And then for after school, I'm a swimmer, actually. I swim on Seco Swimming Association. And we practice every day except Sunday. So 6 days a week, in between 7 and 9 practices every week. So I really don't have any time to do things at the high school. But this year I'm planning on joining the student government just to be kind of a part of that at the school. But other than that, I really don't have any time. So I don't really have a great insight on those kind of things.
Well, we definitely appreciate your being here. And you know, your report, as I said in the email, can be wide ranging. Certainly, you know, feel free to poll some of your fellow students or teachers or administrators or things that they think might be important for you to tell us.
Yeah.
We can do that too if you have a moment. But we appreciate it very much, and this is the point where we traditionally say, we really appreciate your time, we know how busy you are. And you are welcome to stay, but you are free to leave. So thank you very much, Nick, and hopefully we'll see you in October.
Yes, thank you.
It is this Nick. Thank you. All right, moving on. Looks like we don't have anything in particular under action items, so we will continue. So with the financial update, we received in our packet the end of year budget. And so we'll start with that one. So the end of the year, the year that ended June 30th. Katie, do you want to go over anything with us?
Sure, I mean, it's in your packet. We ended the year in a positive balance of $151,491.96. We did have some unanticipated revenue there with Medicaid, so that's good.
Is that included in the 151?
The Medicaid is down below under revenue. See where we budgeted $15,000, we got $22,000, so we got $7,800 more for revenue.
But that's in the 151, right?
No, the 151 is your expenditure side.
So sorry. Thank you.
That's in addition to.
Explain.
I did complete all the DOE end of year reports. You guys signed them last week. Those have been submitted to the DOE, waiting for approval of those. I was going to get a letter to the budget committee ready. I know Marie used to do that for the budget committee for next time when you have your meeting. So I was just waiting for you guys to see this final budget before I prepared that for them.
Is that how you'd like that done, Emily?
That would be awesome.
Yep.
Thank you, Katie.
Okay. Yep.
Other than that, I don't know if anybody had any questions in particular.
It is interesting to note that that the board, for the first time and certainly my time on the board, we overspent. And that was it. As we tried to keep more better communications going.
Oh, you mean at the school board level?
The school board level.
Don't want people to think we overspent our budget.
No.
That's not the case.
It's the first time I have ever seen that the school board overspent their budget.
Yeah, right.
But it went to a good cause. And we learned a lot. We learned a lot along the way. So and the other one, the big number that looks over is that the board had encumbered quite a bit. So, any questions on the budget for last year's budget that is now closed?
Our auditors will be coming I think the first week of November, so it's a little while before they'll get here, but I don't anticipate any major changes.
Right, and they're auditing last year's budget, correct?
Yep.
Yes. And just for the board's understanding, this is the budget that also that will also be used as we set tax rates and things.
Yeah. And so there was a one article put $75,000 into the building fund, so that will happen because you have money left over.
So that will come out of this?
Yes.
$150,000?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So that's important to know. So yeah. That's where that comes out.
And the $1 for this to start up the
Yeah, and the $1. So
yes.
$75,001.
Yes.
Will come out of the
$151,000. And the rest would be returned. So
I always get a little confused by that, but when it comes out, so we wait until that point.
Yeah.
Thank you. So any other questions on last year's budget? All right, then on this year's budget,
It's fairly early, so this is kind of just the first draft of where we are today. We've encumbered salaries and benefits, and more things will get encumbered as the year goes on. Pam gave me a spreadsheet the other day for tuition, Marshwood special ed students, so I'll be going through that to compare it to what we budgeted so that we can encumber those funds.
To actually encumber what we expect to be spent.
Right. And then obviously we haven't received any bills from them yet, so once we do, I'll be able to see what they're billing and all of that. So then those will get encumbered as, in the next couple of weeks, maybe months.
Mm-hmm. I know we kind of have a balance of what should be encumbered and what shouldn't be encumbered, but in the beginning of the year, and we can talk more about it as we go through, but certainly, for instance, 2317, which I think is audit services,
yep.
We know we're going to be audited.
Yep.
And we know that last year it cost more, and we didn't budget more for this year. So that's something I think we need to keep in mind. So
those are the things that we'll be looking at to encumber, you know.
Yeah.
As I go through. Also things, one of the things I do want to talk with Pam about is the special ed transportation.
Yes, because I know.
Because last year, when we were doing the budget, that wasn't encumbered as the year went on, and we ended up overspending by $19,000.
Yes, yes, I have that note here too.
Yeah, so that's one thing I'll be working on with Pam to make sure that we're getting good estimates on that, and those are encumbered going all year, so that way at the end of the year, it's not a huge surprise. So.
How was that billed?
It's billed monthly, but we hadn't received any bills for a while last year. I think I noted at one of our board meetings that, so.
For transportation, yeah, which was odd.
We hadn't been receiving them. So I'm going to work on with her with that, so.
And even though.
And I haven't gotten the first, you know, first student bill yet, so that's why that's not encumbered yet. So those will happen as the year progresses. Probably by your next report next month, you'll see a lot more encumbrances on there.
Yes, and so it's as some of you remember, a number of as recently as 2 years ago, we used to see like for the balance at the bottom, almost nothing because they covered everything. And then we thought, well, we don't really know how much money we have, so the pendulum swung, I think, a little too far the other way. Where now I don't think enough is necessarily being encumbered to give us a good idea of what. We might have, but as long as we know what hasn't been encumbered yet, it helps us think about it as we move forward. So, especially as we move into budget season, which is starting with us. So once we get an idea of, for instance, the transportation, we pretty much know for the regular transportation.
That can be very easy.
And then with the special ed, as we start seeing monthly, we can probably just encumber throughout. So.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I just noticed that was not done last year, so I want to make sure it gets done this year.
Thank you.
So there's no huge surprises. So.
Other questions from the board on this year's budget? We are just starting, so
it's yes, pretty early.
and as we just heard from Bob, we can't count on that yet until we hear from the state, but it's possible that that will be somewhat unanticipated revenue this year.
Yeah, that's unfortunately where it will have to go because yes. We didn't receive it in the same year as we spent it. So,
which is unfortunate because that makes a big difference on our bottom line from last year and what we can do with that money in terms of reducing taxes or keeping our annual reserve. So unfortunately, the timing is that way, but we'll call it a happy misfortune.
And it'll be returned. You can return it back next year. You know what I mean? At the end of this year, it'll be there as an unanticipated revenue to return at the end of next year. So
or to use if we need it for emergencies or whatever comes up or whatever happens. So. All right. Any questions? All right. Thank you, Katie. Two budgets. The late bus, I had asked along the way to make sure that we got sort of a breakdown of ridership if possible and those kinds of things, and in the packet was the email. Katie shared the email thing. So essentially we are charged just over about $32.50 a day is what they charge to run the bus over here with our students. They figure it's a daily average of Rawlinsford students of about 10 students. Certainly, you know, with 10 riders a day, it's essentially, you know, $3.25 a student a day to ride the bus. As ridership goes up, the cost goes down to us, obviously, so. I think this is something we need to keep an eye on. I think if the cost stays that low and if ridership increases, I think that's really good. Is there anything else that any of you would like to know or what your thoughts might be on sort of continuing along with this?
I guess I was under the impression last year that it was lower than that.
Yeah.
But if that's the case.
Bob?
I think you're going to find that it fluctuates depending on the season of the year and the athletics that are going on and other co-curriculars. It might be prudent to just periodically in each season check and see how many people you have riding at that particular time and then adjust accordingly. But
yeah, I mean, I agree with Andrew. We thought thought it was like two or three or something,
right.
Kids, right? Yeah, the price has always been the same. It hasn't gone up substantially. It hasn't gone up at all.
We can certainly check it in a couple of weeks and before how the fall's going.
That increase, 10 is a decent number. Compared to two or three.
Right.
Yeah. It makes me be a little bit more in favor of keeping it.
Right, and if it has indeed gone up last year, toward the end of last year, and the more students we get, and I suppose that's something we could ask the student.
I think too is the great, as kids come and go too, as different needs as kids come in. So you might have different riders that, more participation as kids come in.
Yeah. Right. But I think keeping an eye on it like every season is probably a good idea.
Yeah, we'll let, we're early in September, we'll let that go and perhaps report back in your October meeting, what the ridership has been.
That'd be great. Thank you, Bob.
So John did reach out to me yesterday asking what the status, so is it okay to go ahead and tell him that we'd like to continue this for this year?
Do we have to make a commitment for the year?
I think so. That's what he's looking for. He did email me saying it has started and they wanted to know if you guys were, if it was intended to continue for the year.
Yeah, you asked my question, Bob. I know. And the only reason I even hesitate, I'll share this with the board, is that $3.25 per student, if that's what's happening, we're asking the public to support that, and I think it's a great service. I think we also sort of have to ask, as a parent, as a citizen, if you had to bear the cost yourself, what would you think is a reasonable cost to do it? So it's hard to commit to something without really knowing how it's going to be used, and we know we've had a lot of fluctuation.
We could always ask
him if it's.
Yeah, I was going to say, we can always ask the question if we can do it, at three different sections. We can commit to the first third of the year, watch the ridership, and then we'll decide on the second third of the year. But we can ask the question. So I think I'm hearing if the answer is we got to get to the year, we're going to ride it through, use the bus this year, and keep an eye on our ridership so we can make a more informed decision next year. Is that? But we will ask the question about if we can cancel it or anything.
I think that's, we will commit to the year, but look to.
Yeah, I think we should continue to pay attention to it. I'm in full support of keeping it regardless of whether there's, an average of two or three kids a day or 20 kids a day, because the two or three kids that need it really need it. And if it means that they can get the extra help they need, because we pay $32.47 that day, I am 100% in support of that. Even if it's one kid who needs extra help from a teacher, I think $32 is a pretty fair price to pay.
Yeah, I agree. I would think about this continuing. We pretty much are in concrete with this. This is something we're offering.
And it's
not fair to the kids. I mean, we're sending kids to Marshwood. It's unfortunate that some of them don't live right near the school as some of the other kids do. So there is a bit of a difference. So we need to help make up that difference in distance, and means in some cases providing that extra, that extra bus. I mean, we're really paying for an extra bus almost.
Well, we're not, thank goodness.
That's
a point I want to make. This is a very good deal based on what we were being asked to pay by our own.
I know that, but what I'm saying is that this is actually, they're coming into our town to drop off those kids. So I think that this is a real plus. But as you said, it may be just one, maybe 15, but that one kid is staying after for a reason. We need to be able to support that regardless. We can't just say we're not on the design of. Because we've had this discussion before, and we tried to make it a little bit easier for kids. We managed to move the drop-off into our town where it was over at the old school. So I think this has really been a big plus. It'll continue to be.
I think it will too, but I do want to make the point that the cost, when we were paying $150 a day, that was quite different.
Right.
They were paying $32.
This is really rubbish.
I feel like we struck a really good balance with this, where we're not, you know, it's not that much of a burden on taxpayers, but at the same time, we're offering a really, you know, for kids who need it, and I don't mean want it, I mean need it, then I think we need to offer it, and I feel like it's really important, and I feel like it's worth $4,383 worth of taxpayer money to make sure that kids get what they need, you know.
But I think it's fair just to continue watching it, to make sure it actually is being used by someone.
Totally.
Because if it's not being used by anyone, that's definitely.
Great, so that's, so definitely we'll commit, it sounds like definitely we'll commit, and we would like to get sort of reports on when, on ridership occurs once along the way.
Yeah, they can, I know they don't, the bus driver doesn't tend to count necessarily, right?
That's what the email said, right?
But I guess as they all get off at the Legion, they could kind of.
Could kind of get it.
Get a rough estimate.
They seem to have a rough idea, they seem to be able to get a rough idea.
Right.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, we will.
So we stop it, we'll hear who's.
You'll know.
Quickly answered. All right, so I think both Bob knows where we're going with that. So the next item is the budget timeline draft. So it's here, it's there, does everyone have their, have it in front of them? So we're going to be starting on October 11th, we're going to be starting our first look and discussion of the budget, so we will be starting at 5:30 on the 11th. This is how we've usually done it. Are you not going to be here? It's entirely possible I won't be here either, but I'm going to try to.
That'll be two of us.
Yeah, so anyway, we'll discuss that.
And if you can adjust this too, this was just.
Yeah.
First draft.
We may have to adjust the October, the first discussion, we have to do a slightly, are you around later in October, Tom?
Yeah.
Okay. It's just that day, that week you're going to be out. Alright, anyway, this is sort of, this is the way it's always been set up, we usually have our budget meetings for an hour before the October and November meetings, and then if we need to, we throw one in between if we need to, or if we have to get there. It looks like we are presenting that budget on the 12th. Is that correct, Emily?
I asked you if that was the date you said that. I put that in there. You thought it was the date.
That's the date I told you.
Yes.
That's the date. Yes. I have the budget. That's the, that is.
Based
on this. That's the,
and I did ask.
You did, and I did tell you.
Which seems early.
Which I remember so clearly right now. It's all coming back.
Which just seems, which seems early, but I believe that if it weren't that, it would run into school vacation time. So
it's pretty good timing. See, we have a meeting the next day, so.
No, it should be the other way around.
I know, I guess.
But okay, anyway, so that's going to be happening. Do we have to
change it? I mean, I can have to the budget.
Well, theirs is always Wednesday and we're always Thursday, so. Is that what you mean? So part of it is because the next one is the 19th.
Is that right?
Which is when the town is going to be presenting, I believe.
Right.
We'll get to that. We're getting to that one now. So we may have to change around some of those early ones, but let's give ourselves some time to absorb that.
So don't put it in my phone yet.
All right. So then the public hearing on the budget that is hosted by the budget committee is January 12th. And I believe, is that the, and that's the one that we switched the dates around last time, right? We discussed switching the dates.
No, it was the February date.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
You asked, they asked the school to go on the 9th and the 2nd.
You are correct.
I just have one comment on that. So the 9th is the absolute last day to hold it, but it's February 2nd through the 9th. So if anything were to happen on the 9th with snow or whatever, we would still have to hold it because we don't have, you notice I put no snow date because
I did
we normally build that in because we're always the first Saturday and then we have the second one.
Yep.
If we need it, well, we won't have that moving to the 9th. But we wouldn't, I don't think, have it if the 7th, I mean 2nd either, because they would be on the 9th. I guess we could hold them together.
Well, usually our snow day is the Tuesday
right.
evening, but that's even too.
Yeah, because it says on here on the schedule from the DRA that it's February 2nd through the 9th, so.
Perhaps we try and hold it the Tuesday evening and make the snow day the Saturday.
Saturday.
Well, that will have to be a was that a budget committee discussion?
I can bring that to the budget committee.
Or is it not? It's,
no.
It's, it's
our
it's,
meeting.
No, it's the budget committee's deliberate. Well, you're right. It's our meeting that we do the.
So we can set the date?
I don't know. It's here. It's the SB2 deliberative, so.
Great.
I believe it's the school board's decision on what date you pick. So we'll pick. Why not?
Can we get people to come out on the Tuesday night?
Can you get to the
Saturday
night? Saturday
night. I prefer a Tuesday night.
Yeah, that's true.
Because I like skiing.
Are we looking to get this sort of in stone this evening?
I don't think we need
better,
to.
I suppose, huh? But.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't have to be set in stone tonight, but I think shortly we should set it in stone.
Before the next meeting?
I think you could set it in October and be fine with that. You just don't want to wait too long.
When's the next budget committee meeting?
The 24th of October.
Yeah. I have one in October.
Based on the schedule I have.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, not have, especially with what's been happening these last few winters, not having a snow day would be very, very detrimental.
Yeah,
to what's not really able to get our budget out in front of us to answer questions.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So.
Should we change it? And if there's a problem, then if there's a reason that we shouldn't or can't, we can always.
Because then, what are the other options? The other option is making it in two Saturdays.
No, they have to be between.
They have to be between the 2nd and the 9th.
They have to be between the 2nd and the 9th. I mean, the other option is to do it. Just feel like after the town presentation, but then people are not going to be around. Now, I would suggest that it not start at 7 p.m., however.
Yeah.
No. That we start earlier.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, like 6 p.m.
6. Why not?
Yeah, and now we don't know if there's any conflict with other SAU schedules with other meetings or anything, right?
Well, if we've got a deliberative session, I mean, we will be there one way or another.
Yeah.
If we have to divide and conquer, we can do that tonight.
I mean, deliberative sessions are our most important.
Yeah.
You know,
that's right.
We usually have council here. We usually have.
You're right.
It's our most important meeting of the year with the town. So.
Yeah.
It's in my calendar now. Everyone has to agree.
So instead of the 2nd, it would be the 5th, right?
Yes.
At 6 p.m.?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, instead of the 9th, it'll be the 5th at 6:00.
And then the 9th at a snow date.
Yeah.
I need to check with the minutes, Melissa.
Oh. New stuff all around. So the Saturday date is January 12th, which is the budget committee's meeting. This budget and to have made their deliberations. Okay. So any other questions or comments on the under new business? It says new business, but it's sort of leftover business. So our goals for last year, we'll do a quick review of our goals for last year and then sort of chat about how we think we did and all that. And then publicly read out, although many of you have probably already seen them, our goals for this year, this school year, 2018-2019 calendar. So last year we had, our goals were to, as a board, we're to place the teachers on the appropriate salary step based on their qualifications and experience, communicate consistently and clearly with all stakeholders, and investigate ways to work more closely with our town boards and committees to pool resources, save time, and save money. So overall, thoughts on how that went and how what we did, what we could do better?
Well, I think there's always room for improvement, right? Especially on the last item, working with the town.
Yep, we can do better with that this year, and I'd like to continue to improve our communication. Not sending a printed newsletter, I'm not going to do that, but maybe write some more FAQ documents and figure out how to get those a little bit more exposure so that people know how to find them, where to find them, mm-hmm. and are interested to find them. Open to other communication improvements that are suggested.
And I think, you know, number one, with the help of the union and all of us working very hard and the budget committee's support. For that was really remarkable. I think the whole town really worked to get the teachers on the appropriate step, and it was a big step for the town, and overdue as we all know, but still a big step, and it was good to get that done. And in terms of, all right, so some of this will come up as we talk about the current ones, but in terms of communication, maybe I believe there are newsletters to go out from RGS. Maybe at some point just have a little box that shows here's where you can find frequently asked questions on what website. Maybe you could go home to at least parents of RGS students, and of course we want to get it out to parents of Marshman students too. Try to figure out ways to do that. All right, so in our goals for the coming year, support the superintendent and principal to ensure a successful transition. Share the board is sort of tasked itself with sharing institutional knowledge and certainly communicating our availability and the availability of how we can get things done. And most importantly, to provide clear directives to both the superintendent. Superintendent is the one we provide the directive to, and we don't want to confuse it by also providing directives necessarily to Rich, but anyway, to be clear, whenever we do provide the directives. Consistent budget communication throughout the year, and it looks like we sort of refined that a little bit about budget stuff, so budget communication. So one of the things under that is to standardize a communication format. And I think think Bob and Katie were going to be working on some ways. We can already see that we have sort of a streamlined budget to review. Doesn't give us all the level of detail, but it gives us the level of detail that we need, I think. So those are the things that we're looking at changing across the board. And a monthly report at board meetings. Is that a monthly report?
That's from us to the public.
Oh, okay.
Because it's in our packet and we address certain bits and pieces that we have questions about, but that isn't really clear to everyone sitting here necessarily what the overall picture looks like, where, you know, just kind of make it more clear to the general public what we're talking about and what things look like and what's costing money and what's, you know, a surprise here and there, you know, just each month, so that at the end of the year when we say, you know, or at some point we're freezing the budget, people aren't taken aback by.
I think it's great, and I know that the update you did at the last budget committee meeting I thought was fantastic. And I think that something like that, if you could take that on as the budget committee rep and do it also, that way, if you do it every month, you'll be ready to go.
I will be ready for my budget committee.
I think that's a great idea.
That is a great idea.
Yeah. Anyone else jump in here? I'm just sort of going down the list. The next one is to find a way to address paraprofessional compensation inequities. We'll be adding this as a board agenda item and discussion, just so we keep it in front of us. It will be a focus during our collective bargaining negotiations. And we definitely want to encourage our paraprofessional representation at the negotiation table. I think it's very important. So those are things that we're going to be working on. Anyone want to jump in on that? And continue to work with town boards and committees to pool resources. While we're on this, so the first bullet under that is essentially check in with Dick Fortier on his availability and amenability to be part of that, because he's someone who could help do some things together. And to check in with the select board for George Gilmet, who is our road agent, who watches over pretty much everything in town to see if they can work together. I think most of us up here know that there's a lot that happens between the town and the school already. I think probably Dick and George, I know Dick and our former road agent, and Dick and George probably do things already. We may not even know all that they do, but I know that they do things together. But to make it a little bit more formal, and maybe identify a few items where we can actually measure the savings that we have for the town or for the school, which is, it all comes out of the same taxpayer's pocket. So let's figure out some things that can happen. But I think one of the things that would be important, I think, Bob, you mentioned that you would like to sort of get introduced to the select board and chat with them.
Yeah, I haven't done the select board yet. I wanted to meet with Dick first, and actually I'm meeting with Rich and Dick tomorrow afternoon, and we're going to discuss this topic. And then as soon as I wanted Dick aware of what was going on first, and then after that I'll get in touch with the select board and be on their agenda.
Excellent.
So I'll touch base with them.
Okay. I think it's just very nice. Again, in my history, I don't know if the superintendent ever attended the select, you know, went to meet the select board, so I think that would be a very nice thing to do. Very nice. Any other?
No, certainly if we can find other ways to save money and measure it, it would be a great priority. I think everybody in the town would agree with that, for sure.
I think so. And I know that people in town have mentioned that one of the skills that Dick has, if he has, again, we have to figure out the time and how much of his time might get spent on this, is he knows a lot about buildings. Mm-hmm. So, and the town does not have anyone who knows a lot about buildings.
Sure.
All right. So those are our goals for this coming year, and we'll be checking in on those as we move along. Under old business, we have the community connections and the FAQs. At this point, we're just getting rolling again, so.
Anyone have any topics for FAQs that come to mind that would be helpful?
Maybe we should do a profile of our new administrator.
I think that would be excellent.
Who are they?
Wait, we need to get.
Well, I think it would be nice for the community,
yeah,
and for
sure.
Parents who don't get into the school or the SAU office very often to have a, you know.
I think it would be great.
An introduction.
I think we need to get a sixth grader who wants to do an independent project.
Totally.
Interviews, right? Or a fifth or sixth grader.
For sure.
Well, so we'll just turn that all over to Rich.
Way to pass the buck, too.
So to introduce Superintendent Budomski and Principal Hartford.
I think that would be interesting to do.
Yeah. People. I think a student interview, right? Yeah. For you.
Yeah,
unless one of you wants to take out your reporter's hat, your trench coat.
Keep playing with the reporter, thank you. No.
All right, that'd be great. All right, that'd be great if something like that can happen. I'm sure some student will be more than happy to interview.
So, what specifically are you asking me to do? One of your goals?
Yes.
That's right. Passing the buck. No, how? Yeah. Maybe you and I could talk about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That would be excellent.
Actually, it's supposed to go through the ball first.
And
collaborate.
And we have a new administrative assistant, correct? Is that true?
Yes.
Here?
Yes, we were very fortunate, unfortunate, mm-hmm. in some respects, because Caroline was a huge help in the transition process for me. But we were lucky that we had a lot of qualified candidates interview and apply, and I think we found somebody. Doesn't have any school experience, but has a lot of administrative assistant experience, and she's learning fast. And she's making connections with kids, and she's wanted to get into a school setting for some type of job for many years, and she finally figured out that she has a skill set that is needed in schools, and started applying for administrative assistant positions. So don't ask me to pronounce her last name. Allison. Miss Allison.
All right.
It would be great, actually, to also include a profile on her, especially for parents who haven't been in and met her. And
yeah.
The face of the school?
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a very critical role.
Yeah, sure. We received her emails.
That's good. Good stuff. All right. Future meetings. Our next meeting, which is going to start with our opening budget committee meeting at 5:30, is October 11th, and the regular school board meeting will take place at 6:30. Tom has already indicated that he will not be able to attend on the 11th. I expect to be able to attend, but I'll discuss it with you later. I'm planning a road trip, and we'll be back that week sometime. But it's possible anyway. I will keep you all informed.
Can I also remind the board that the SAU 56 joint board meeting is next Tuesday? Originally scheduled for Monday, it was moved to Tuesday night at Holman's Grove in the CPC.
So we have these meetings at 5:30
on the 11th. Any particular school events that are coming up?
I see my report. The food clinic.
Well, I remember seeing that.
That's it.
Oh yeah, you do have them here. You do have school events and dates in here.
Yeah.
I tend to always look on the agenda for them, so it's if it would be possible, Rich, for you to share those. with Bob so they can get on the agenda. Each time that would be really helpful, with these dates.
So take those dates and put them on there.
I mean, it's nice to have them in here, but I think it's also, but it's also good to have them on the agenda so that they're all sort of all in one place. Is it?
Just captured, basically. Mm-hmm.
Now, we don't necessarily need to know, well, I don't know, picture dates, nice to know. Mm-hmm. It is nice to know all these dates, actually.
Do you want to come over and get your picture taken?
Oh, you never know. School flu clinic, you know, telling you, that, well, you can come and get the flu. Hopefully not. Hopefully not.
No. That's being sponsored by Goodwin Community Health out of Summersworth.
Oh, great.
They do a lot of school districts in the area. They reached out to us this summer.
So it's new. Is that new this year, though?
Yes, yeah, first time we've done it.
Ever.
Really?
Ever.
Well, that's fantastic.
We have 42 signed up. Yeah. That's significant.
It's extremely convenient.
Yeah.
Good.
Really grateful for that.
It's a great charge.
Yeah. Yeah. That's really wonderful.
That's students.
I think that's absolutely amazing. Of course, I mean, there's probably work involved in getting parents' permission and everything, but it's a wonderful thing. Absolutely a wonderful thing. I know that. I love working at a place where you can go and get a flu shot. It's great. All right, thank you for that. Closing comments by visitors.
Celia Leopold, 426 Washington Street. You put your date for your budget meeting on the first Tuesday of the month. If you want to coordinate with town events, that is also the regularly scheduled night for the town's planning board. So you're automatically putting yourself in conflict with that group that meets every first Tuesday of the month. I don't know if that matters to you.
It doesn't matter if it matters to us or not. We are under a calendar constraint.
So I was just going to suggest that if you're meeting that following Thursday, maybe make it part of your meeting or do it Wednesday night instead. It would still fit into your calendar if you do it Wednesday or Thursday night and then have your snow date on Saturday. I don't know if that works for your schedule or not, but it's just the thought that you say you want to work with the town and this is a standing meeting that's every first Tuesday of every month and has been for several years.
I think it's a good point. I think it's worth checking in with the planning board chair. Do we know who that is?
That would be newly appointed because the planning board chair was just appointed to the select board. Mm-hmm.
So there is no planning board chair at the moment, is what you're saying?
That will probably be determined at their next meeting.
Okay, thank you.
Also, if you want to work with the town, I would suggest reviewing the video or the notes from the select board Monday night, because the water district just had a discussion with the town about coordinating with them for winter plowing, and it was brought up that the town coordinates with the school, and that was part of the select board discussion, but you can get more in-depth information from their notes.
Thank you.
And I had one more question on the security upgrades. Will there be a public hearing or a chance for the public to express their comments or concerns?
You mean the safe and secure entrance that we're talking about?
Yes.
Certainly at the point where we have to make any decisions, yes, the public will be invited in. Any other contact?
Tracy Glorian, just the bus thing. I'm on little. I am also, oh, I'm tired, I'm sorry. I am for the bus to continue. There we go. It's hard for parents and children to rely on the bus being there if it's maybe there, maybe not there, maybe this season, maybe not this season. There's like soccer going on, there's volleyball going on, there's after school programs going on, there's extra help stuff, there's plays, there's all kinds of stuff always going on at the school. If the kids and the families know that bus is always going to be there, per se, you know, as long as it's popular and that kind of stuff, they can rely on it. I know that when we were, well, maybe we'll do it for a couple months or maybe we'll not, I was hearing a lot of parents very concerned with, well, maybe my child won't be able to do this because there might not be a bus there and I can't get home in time to do this. So I'm, I would just say I'm for also, as a townsperson, a bus being able to be there for our students who are out of our town, being brought into our town for a really good price. So I just, I think that families being able to know that that bus is there is really important for them to be able to schedule their seasons, their activities, the rest of their year type of thing. So that's just my feeling.
Any other comments?
Lori Hatz, 48 Sackville Circle. I agree with Tracy. The town voted to send the kids to Marshwood. We need to take care of the Marshwood kids.
Our Marshwood kids.
Yeah. And if Marshwood kids are entitled, kids who live in Marshwood are entitled to those services, and the kids who live in Rollinsford need to be entitled to those services as well. So there you go.
Thank you. Any other comments by visitors? Comments by the board?
What were you going to say about the book?
Oh, yeah. So, interestingly enough, as you probably, some of us have probably noticed, the cupola was not repaired this last year, as we had hoped that it would be, as we had encumbered money to do it. It was unfortunate, but there were a lot of sort of communication snafus that happened, and so it didn't take place. Interestingly enough, just this last Wednesday, I had a citizen talk to me at the dump, saying, "Hey, what's going on with the cupola? It looks like..." I said, "Well, yes, totally agree with you, and we're working on it." So it didn't happen. I think as a board, we need to look at our budget, and as early as next month, come up with a clear directive if we feel we have the money, or maybe get a new quote or something.
Did we not encumber the money?
We did encumber the money last year. However, it did not. There were a number of twists and turns that happened with communication, and it simply did not get done. We had a quote. At the end of the year, I was told that it was not going to be the low end of the quote, it was going to be the high end of the quote, but we had already encumbered enough money, so we were going to go forward with it, and then,
I just want to say that Rich did a lot of legwork when he started July 1st to try to track that down. It hadn't been scheduled at that point. Rich did a lot of work with Dick to get a quick estimate, get it scheduled. It was actually scheduled a couple of times this summer to be completed. We were told that the people we were contracting with got busy because of the heat and the rain initially in the front end of the summer, got backed up and couldn't do it in a timely manner. And we got to the point, because it was out of last year's funds, that we got to a point where we could no longer pay for that out of last year's funds, so we have to pull the plug on.
What was the high end cost?
It was $7,500. And if people feel strongly, we can take an action tonight. But I think, I wonder if we need to get a new quote or get back with the person who gave us the original quote.
I guess the question now is, so are these the folks that we would still want to do it? I mean, were they recommended by Dick or somebody else?
Yeah.
So it was just a timing thing, and the weather.
In talking with Dick, he said if the board chooses to move forward, you know, later, whenever, he would look to find at least one other person to give us a quote beyond the people that had given us the first one.
Well, I think one of the actions we could take this evening is to authorize getting those quotes and how quickly they could get started, getting that information, and then we would have enough information to make a decision.
Well, if you need a motion, I make a motion that we authorize the getting the quote.
Thanks. We have a second from Emily. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. So let's move forward with that as quickly as possible. See where we stand. town will be good, we'll see if we're getting money from the state.
Yeah.
Next month, so in a couple of weeks we'll know that. All right, any, so other comments by visitors? Tom, you got, did you have anything else you wanted to say? Emily? All right, we do have non-public, so we will take a roll call to go into non-public.
Judy Nelson?
Yes.
Tom Coons? Emily Leach?
Here.
Andrea Anderson?
Here.
Erin Kavanaugh?